Well, hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcraft. Nice to see you again. As you can see, I'm out in my camp and enjoying the early spring here in Denmark. It's a wonderful weather, no wind, and the sun is shining almost from a blue sky. So it's really great to be out here. And as you saw, I have this knife, or I think it's a dagger, because it has two edges that I can use. And there's a little story behind this one, and I'll tell you in a minute. Well, my video title is called The Beauty and the Beast, and that is because this one is the beast, and I'll show you what the beauty is. So hang on. Yeah, and this is what I'll call the beauty. Isn't it just beautiful, this little Kuxa I carved recently? It's not the carving that I'm calling beauty. I'm very pleased with it, but it's the grain that this piece of wood has. It's a burl that I bought from Signafors in Sweden, and it's a burl from a birch tree. And you can see the grains in here, very special. And when I get a piece from Signa, it's very hard for me to see how the grains are. It's first when I'm finished carving it and put it in, giving it some oil, then the magic happens, and you can see very nice grain here. So I'm really glad for this, and I will call it a beauty because it is beautiful. I carved it a little bit rough here on the surface, on the outside, because I like it to be, as you can see, it's handmade. Inside it's very smooth, so that the coffee doesn't go down in the wood, if that's a problem. And I put a little oil on it now because it enhanced the grain in the woods. So it's not going to be that glossy when it's when there's no oil on it. So this is my new little Kuxa. I'll still use my black Kuxa, but this one will be one of my favorites. I'm sure of that. Yeah, and this is the beauty, and this is the beast. And out here today, I'm going to make me a lunch. I got some things I can bake a bread from. I'm going to do that in a moment. Those of you who haven't seen my video where I bake a bread in my zebra pot, you'll have the chance now to see how I do that. I made the dough back home and brought it here. So now I'm going to light my fire and of course show you how I'm baking my bread. And beside that, it's time for a new shout out of the month. And this gentleman is a very friendly guy. I love his videos, and I'll tell you about him a little bit later. So now light up the fire so we can start baking the bread. So hang on. Yeah. And this is my zebra pot, a large model. And in here I have a piece of dough I made home this morning. And this is actually something you could put in here, and I customized it by taking off these edges so it could go down here and make a little oven. So this is where the bread will be, and I put it in here like this. Then I put the lid on and secure it with this wire, go through here so the lid won't come off, won't fall off. This is how it looks. And when there's only coals, then I put it on down in the coals and put some coals on top of that. And for that I have made this. I'll show you. I was going to cook for about 18 minutes, 20 minutes, and then it should be finished. Just have to put some more on top here. So now it's been on the fire for about 17 minutes. I'm going to see how the bread is looking. Actually looking good. Give it a couple of minutes more, just to be sure. See if I can get this one on. here to cool off and make my coffee finished. Little salt in. Just wait for it to boil. A little bit burned there, so that's okay. Well, let's see. Yeah, it's nice. Here, I have some butter. Oops. Here's some boysenberry jam. Ah, doesn't that look nice? Very delicious. Now I'm only going to take my coffee. Let's take my cookser here. I'm gonna use this. My black cookser. Just gonna fetch my coffee. Yeah. Yeah, and as many of you know, I prefer this brand of coffee, Lemmelkaffe, Lemmel coffee from the northern part of Sweden. And this is a new kind I haven't tasted before. It's organic coffee, and well, it tastes really good, I can tell you that. And also so on the website, they are going to make, or they're making some coffee they call whiskey coffee. And as far as I can tell when I'm reading on the website, they are putting the beans in some empty whiskey barrels and keep them for some month, and then the coffee will take a little bit taste from the whiskey. And I can only say I can recommend that, because whiskey and coffee is very nice together. And on every every package from Lemmel coffee, you get a little portion of salt you can put in your coffee. It's just ordinary salt. You can use your own salt back from home, but they deliver one package of salt with each package of coffee. So I really enjoy Lemmel coffee. It's the best coffee I ever tasted, and especially made for cooking coffee, cowboy coffee or Sami coffee. So yeah, now for this little dagger or knife. I actually have had it for many, many years. In 1971, I was a little child living up in Skagen, in the top of Denmark, and there was an American film company that was recording, making a movie up there. The movie is called King Lear, and I put a link to IMDb so you can see which video it's about. And after they finished the video, and it was several months, and all the town for on the town people were out looking where the films were recorded. And after, when they were finished, all their gear, the things they used in the movies, were sold on. So you could buy that. And I think my father bought this for me, and I have it, and I've had it for many years. And I just found it in my attic some month ago, and I put a little thing on the handle here, so it looks old school, and I begin to sharpen it. And I'm sure this is cast iron, and I know cast iron is very brittle, I think it's called. But the other day I actually dropped it on a concrete floor, and nothing happened. It didn't broke, and I was very glad for that, of course. But this little knife or dagger was in the movie called King Lear. It was recorded in 1971 up in something called Robbermühle, which is almost a desert in the northern part of Denmark. And I know a lot of other people bought axes and swords and so on, but I only have got this one. I'm very glad for it. It's very old school. I love it very much. So, and of course I have that video with the King Lear that was recorded where I lived, and it's awesome to see all the things they built up in the desert. They built a fort and had a lot of horses and battle scenes and so on. And if you are interested and you can find it, then you can go in it and check it out. It's really awesome. And now the shout out of the month. And this time I'm going to tell you a little bit about a guy called Jason Eek. He lives in Canada and has a very awesome channel. I know he's building something. He's building canoes, and at the moment he's building a little tiny house on wheels that he's going to use out in the wilderness and can sleep in there. And he also makes a lot of videos where he's on canoe trips out in the Canadian wilderness, and it's very, very good videos, very high quality. And Jason is a guy that's approximately about my age and is doing a lot of outdoor living, canoe trips in the Canadian wilderness, and building canoes and a little tiny house, as I said before. So if you haven't checked him out, do that. Of course, I put a link below, and see, I'm sure it will be something for you. If you like my videos, I think we have very much the same style in making videos. I think you'll like that one too. So check him out, Jason Eek from the Canadian wilderness. Yeah, and look at this. I painted my roof black with tar paint. I like it black, and the tar is going down in the paper and making it even more waterproof. I've had a little problems sometimes with the rain that dripped in. I don't know where it came from, but I think this will solve the problem too. So now the roof is sealed with this coating of tar paint. I don't know what it's called in English. In Danish we call it roof tightening. So, and it was actually the other day I saw my footage with my drone. I thought, well, this roof is too bright. It's not black, it's gray. And well, it was supposed to be black. So now it is black because I've painted it. Hope you like. Well, this is all for now, folks. Hope you enjoyed my little video from Kimber Camp in a wonderful spring day here in Denmark. I hope you're safe and well out there, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.